gal to give me some.
I asked that gal to give me some. She says, wait till the taters is done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. Threw her on the floor and I knocked off some. I wish to God I'd passed her by. I wish to God I'd passed her by. Taters got burned and so did I.
Top of your opinions, miss.
Is that so?
Yeah. Now make yourself useful. And the first part of useful is not driving me insane with your constant complaining.
Oh, you say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna kill you.
You come near me, sailor, and I'll slice you up.
You put that knife down or you could be missing a hand.
What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. Was there insufficient feathers in your pillow?
I ain't lazy, Mr. Morgan. I'll work, but not this.
Well, ain't cooking work?
My husband and I, we shared the work. All of it. I was out in the fields. I can hunt, carry a knife, or use a gun. But I tell you, you keep me here, I'll skin this fat old coot and serve him for dinner!
Watch your damn mouth, you crazy goddamn fishwife!
Enough, both of you! Well, come with me then. You wanna head out there, run with the men? So be it. But we do more than just hunting. We're hunted. And them things hunting us, well, they got guns of their own.
I ain't afraid of dying.
Good. You need anything, Mr. Maybe me and Mrs. Zad are gonna take a little ride.
Yeah, sure. Here's my list, and can you post this letter for me while you're there?
Sure. Come on, princess. Are you coming with me then, woman?
So I've graduated from chopping vegetables to shopping?
Shut your goddamn mouth.
What is up, YouTube? It's your boy Trev Goat here. A little under the weather today, so if I don't talk much in the next couple episodes, that is why. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day. And just enjoy some Red Dead. And hope you guys enjoy it too. Hope, see you later.
Killing's okay, but letter reading's where we draw the line.
Mm. Here.
Dear Aunt Kathy.
You are something else.
I haven't heard from you in some time, so I pray to the Lord above that your health has not deteriorated further. Blah, blah, blah. It's boring. Wait a sec. Listen to this. Since we last corresponded, I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself. Before you ask, I am still yet to take a wife, but I can assure you it's not for a lack of suitors. You ever actually even talk to a woman he ain't paid for?
Oh, look, we're all hiding behind something.
And what's this? Return to Tacitus Kilgore.
Oh, that. Now that's Dutch's idea. All mailed and sent to the same alias. Whatever we set up somewhere new, Strauss, he heads into town. Tells him to start expecting mail from a Tacitus Kilgore, whatever they changed it to. Here, give me that back. We got work to do. Oh, Okay, here we are.
So, what's the plan? I shoot the shopkeeper while you...
No! You insane?
I thought we was outlaws.
Outlaws? Not idiots. We rob fools that rob other people. These people, they're just trying to get by. So you head on in there and you buy us some food to eat. There are no guns.
You sure?
This time, there'll be time for killing soon enough.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna go check the mail. Nothing exciting. Yes, I would like to post a letter.
All right. Okay, no trouble.
Thank you.
Bye now.
I think this is everything.
Thanks. Here. Take that for yourself, okay?
Thanks.
We'll give it back then. Jesus. I didn't ask for his goddamn help.
Why don't you drive?
Okay.
Come on, lady. Get a move on.
I like Sadie, not lady.
I know. So, you get everything?
I think so.
And some... new clothes, I see.
Don't start. I can wear what I damn well want. Like I told you, my husband and I shared all the work. I wasn't some little wife with a flower in her hair baking cherry pies all day.
Yeah, I don't doubt that. You sure look the part now. Won't be long before you're smoking cigars and playing the harmonica.
I'll have you know, I used to love playing the harmonica before. Well, my house and everything I own got burned to the ground.
I know. I'm real sorry about what you... you know. Maybe I'll keep my eye out for another one.
I don't want no pity. Just treat me equal and know nobody's taking...
Just don't kill the camp cook.
Hey there!
Hey.
What you folks up to?
Just heading home.
You're in Lemoyne Raider country.
Keep it cool,
Steve. You need to pay a toll to pass through here.
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? How about you pull over right now?
Pull over?
That's what I said.
Hey, how's about this?
Shit! Let's get the hell out of here! What the hell was that?
They was gonna rob us! Yeah!
New pair of pants? Think you're landing, Rick?
Oh, I'm gonna run this son of a bitch down!
You ain't gonna win this!
Well, wanted to see some action, lady. Now you got your... what?
Oh,
we're good here, Arthur.
Ah, shoot. All right, I'll drive us back.
Probably shouldn't linger here too long.
Here.
Why?
Because you've caused enough trouble already.
I'm fine. Careful now. We showed those bastards, huh?
Remind me not to get on your bad side.
And they was clearly planning to bushwhack us.
Did good. But that's a lot of mess to make near camp. Hope it don't bring anyone sniffing around.
Are you gonna tell Dutch?
Maybe. If he asks. But maybe not.
So who do they say they were? Lemoyne Braiders?
Yeah, something like that. Who knows? Anyway, don't you go ribbing Pearson about that letter.
How dare you? I wouldn't dream of it.
Right, you wouldn't.
I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself.
I won't be giving you no mail to post. Anytime soon, that's for sure.
I just want to peek in that journal of yours. The mind boggles.
Not a chance.
You didn't get yourself killed then, Miss Adler.
Not quite.
Well, I'd like to say I missed your refined conversations, but I'd be lying.
I enjoyed myself out there.
Yes, we, Mrs. Adler did okay.
At shopping?
Yes, at shopping.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Don't mention it. I would ride with you again, Mrs. Adler, if you will ride with me.
Maybe. If you prove you can handle yourself.
Well, they say I lack finesse, but I ain't afraid of gun smoke.
We got this, Arthur. You've already done me a big favor today. Okay, Miss High and Mighty. And nice pants, by the way.
Oh, shut up.
How you doing, old friend?
Fine.
It's funny, us ending up down here. My daddy died in the field in Pennsylvania, fighting this lot. I ever tell you that?
Many times.
I see I'm boring you, Arthur.
Worrying me. We lost men back there.
We have lofty goals, Arthur. We're trying to reform society to a kinder, truer, better way. Now, of course, there's gonna be casualties.
We're thieves. In a world that don't want us no more.
We are dreamers in an ever duller world of facts. Now, I'll give you that, but come on. We got the day. It's nice out.
Old Jose says that there's a creek around here. I reckon it's full of fish.
Hey, old girl, come on down here. Why don't you show us this creek you've been pissing in?
Hey. You don't look too rosy, old friend. I thought this warmer weather would...
My days are looking good and long over, Dutch.
Always bring crushing trouble for you.
Come on, Hosea. Let's go with it.
All right, gentlemen. Let me show you how it's done.
Fish here. There's a whole lake of them.
Because I need to get out for a bit. Me and the old guard. Before any of them back there, there was us.
The curious couple and their unruly son.
It feels good here. You did well finding that spot, Arthur.
More Charles than me.
It's like I can breathe again, thick and soupy as this air is. Might even do your whistling pipes some good, Hosea.
I was once in this country with Bessie. Feels like a lifetime ago.
It was a lifetime ago. But what a life we have lived, how well we have fought, especially both of you.
I hope so.
But now, when things are desperate, we have to stick with the plan. Make enough money, then find somewhere where nobody will find us. Where we don't have to hide.
Like where?
I got some ideas hatching, but I need you with me, not against me. Both of you.
Of course.
Still, we do need money. So keep a low profile, especially in the local town. After Valentine, I want everyone on best behavior here. No trouble. But start turning over the soil and the rocks. See what turns up.
Dutch, we've got to be discreet.
Imagine what a slew of rich simpletons there must be down here. Oh, this is perfect for you, Hosea. You'll be able to play them like a fiddle.
Nothing would give me greater pleasure, but...
No buts. Not today. We fish and we enjoy the day. Looks like law up ahead. Play it cool.
Hold. Gentlemen.
Well, look what the cat drug in.
I seem to have gotten myself in a spot. But...
Quiet back there.
Let's see if we can't sort this out. How are you, boys?
Fine.
This is quite some country you have here.
We like it well enough.
Hoagie McIntosh, at your service.
Lee Gray. This is my deputy, Archibald McGregor.
It's good to meet you.
You a Scot?
Partly. The best part.
Of course.
Now, tell me, sir, what did the silly, fancy fop back there do? Nothing too terrible, I trust.
He was accused of running a gold mining investment scam.
Oh, no. I'm sure he wasn't. He is a magician. I know him. He's a fool. But he is not a bad fellow. Now, can we just...
I wouldn't do that if I were you!
Shit! The Anderson boys! I can't have more scandal!
Well, allow us to help, my friend. Arthur!
Chase wanted, man.
And take Archibald with you.
Just what I signed up for. Come on, big guy!
Perhaps we can discuss the foolish magician.
Stay with that train! Don't let them get away! Keep your guns holstered. We need them Anderson boys alive.
Shit.
Come on, hurry!
All right.
Come on, we're losing them.
Will you relax? We're not losing them.
Faster, come on. What's your name, sir?
Arthur Callahan.
Faster, Mr. Callahan, please. My neck is on the line here.
I get it. I'm doing my best. Looks like the son of a bitch is gonna make it. You sure I can't just shoot him?
No! Did I not say that?
You said plenty.
Look at you two fellas all curled up!
Idiot! Now get after the others. Come on! The train is slowing down to go through the station. Now's our chance. See if you can get alongside the train.
Yeah.
See the flat carriage? Head for that. Get us as close as you can. Watch out! He's throwing bottles at us! You think you can jump on there?
Me? Why me?
Because you ride like my grandpa!
Come, bastards! They didn't do nothing! Go to hell! Get the hell off!
Running ain't gonna help.
kid? Come on!
Are you sure?
Do it! Bring him out here.
Deputy?
Sounded like quite a commotion. Is that him?
I sincerely hope so.
Old Anders Anderson.
So what now?
Take him in. Come on. A fine job. Well done. And a pat on the back for me for stopping the train. There you go. You are a natural. All right, let's take him in. Follow me.
What about the others?
Oh, we'll round them up. Anders back there is the brains of the operation, and that's really saying something.
You're the boss.
That was mighty impressive, sir. I have to admit, I'd hazard a guess you've served the law yourself at some point.
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that.
Are you familiar with the area here?
No, not really.
On your right here, these tobacco fields? This is part of Calaga Hall, big estate belonging to the Gray family.
Looks bone dry.
Yes, we are in dire need of some rain round here, let me tell you. The Grays have lived in Calaga Hall for generations. Fine people. My family's been working for them for years. Sheriff Gray's the one I know best, of course, but they own half the businesses in town.
Which town?
Rhodes, sir. You don't know it? Where we're headed right now. Ain't what it was before the war, but it has its charms. I'm sure you already know of the Braithwaites.
Like I said, just got down here.
Another big family in these parts. They have an estate west of here. Awful people, truly awful. They've been fighting with the Grays for as long as I can remember.
Sounds like quite the place you got here.
We're gonna bear left here. Very reputable saloon owned by the Gray family. We also have a general store, gunsmith, post office, train station, of course.
What more do you need?
Oh, good, they're back. And that's your friend, right?
Yep.
Okay, we're gonna stop just ahead on the right, outside the sheriff's office. Can you grab Anders off your horse and carry him in for me? Chop, chop. Don't just leave him slumped on there for the whole town to see. Carry him over, then.
Hey, fellas.
Mr. Gray! We got him.
Very good.
I told you Arthur would deliver. Man has a passion for justice.
That's wonderful.
So, about my friend here?
Your idiot friend is free to go. But no more trouble from you, partner.
I promise you, this was all just a big misunderstanding. However, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I'll pretend to appreciate that. Mr. McIntosh, it has been a real pleasure. The mostly good citizens of Rhodes, we welcome you.
Well, we're just honored to be here.
And make your friend behave. We got enough trouble from some of the residents, old-timers who've gone sadly to seed and lost their dignity.
How terrible. Come along now. I will keep this fellow on the straight and narrow.
Come back and see us sometime soon. Excuse me, gentlemen. Oh, these better be ugly rumors. Is it true you were seen talking to that wretched Penelope Braithwaite?
I can't thank you enough.
Where have you been?
Around.
And where are you staying?
I'm renting a caravan on the edge of town behind the church. It's horrible, but no one comes looking. The whole town is trapped in this interminable feud between the two families. His lot, Gray's, and Braithwaite's.
Interesting.
Two old plantation houses falling out. Rebel gold. Marrying cousins, not marrying...
Arthur, Jose, you start poking around. See what you can find out about that.
I have missed you, boys. I've heard about bounty.
There's been a price on my head for 13 years. It'll take a month to find us down here. And it seems like we can have a little sport.
Well, they're good bounties.
Where you hear this?
Some fellas I met at a camp near the state line said there was talk of it in bars in the north and west for 500 miles. There was talk of super agents of some sort.
Super agents? I'd love to meet one. It's just talk.
I'm sure it is, but I couldn't not tell you.
Stay out of trouble.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Okay, so these two plantation families. Arthur, you start sniffing around the Gray's place, see what the story is there.
Yeah, I passed by it earlier with our friend, Archibald.
Good. Hosea, you see what you can find out about these Braithwaites.
All right. Thank you, Arthur.
Quite a fishing trip.
There's still time. I'm up for it.
How about you, Arthur? Have you had enough of the chase for one day?
Sure, why not?
Great. Hosea, why don't you lead us to that spot you were talking about? Kinda like this place.
Okay. Let's see if we can avoid any more excitement. Gentlemen, follow me.
Ain't nothing new.
Oh. Hey, so how far is this creek?
It's a bit of a ride still, and it's not a creek. It's the same lake we camped on, just a different pipe. It'll be worth it. I saw some big drum and sturgeon there. Should be rock bass, bluegills, perch, pickerel too. It's a good spot.
We'll see if you're as good at catching fish as you are at catching criminals, Arthur.
Trelawney owes me for that.
Trelawney owes everyone for something, but his information is good.
Plus, we are now ingratiated with the local law. I'd say it was a worthwhile diversion all around.
Oof. Where is this spot, Hosea? Timbuktu?
Not too much farther. Anyway, you two never told me properly about that business with Cornwall in Valentine. What happened there? Apart from scaring the living daylights out of Mr. Strauss.
That was about the only upside. John and I didn't even have time to get paid for the sheep we rustled.
It is safe to say Mr. Cornwall isn't a man to let bygones be bygones.
Ambushed us in the saloon. He came with a lot of guards and what seemed like just about every lawman in the county.
We've had closer shaves, but not that many.
And if Cornwall found us, the Pinkertons couldn't have been far behind.
They found me when I was fishing with Jack, remember?
Listen, it was good we moved when we did, but that mess is behind us now.
Yes. Jack told me you were a good teacher when you took him fishing. I said he must have you confused with someone else.
Very funny. Hey there, mister.
Well, hey.
One of those days.
So, you're going back to see that Sheriff Drake?
Yeah, I don't see why not. They don't know who we are down here.
He didn't seem the sharpest attack. Neither did that deputy.
This is the spot. Down to the left there.
Behind you.
Okay, go. Cole.
I saw some boats around last time. Be good to get to deeper water. Yes, over there on the shore. Skip! Hold it. I'm sure nobody would mind if we borrowed one of these. Come on. All right. This looks like a fine vessel.
Okay. Come on, Arthur. Let's get her in the water.
I got a good feeling about fishing here. You're supposed to be some incredible sturgeon.
Oh. Okay, here we go. Let me row. You boys are too old for real labor no more.
You're too dumb for anything else.
You're still too quick for me, old man.
I enjoy picking on children. Now take us to the deeper water and pray for good luck and stupid fish.
What about stupid luck and good fish?
That'll do too. Keep going.
All right. Good luck, gentlemen.
Should really come here at dawn or dusk. That's when you catch the best fish. We should use a lake lure. That'll give us a much better chance of hooking something big like a sturgeon.
What's wrong with a good old worm?
Worms are good for... tiddlers like bluegill and rock bass, but... you'd have to be real lucky to catch a sturgeon with one.
Lures it is, then. You heard the expert, Arthur. Let's bait up.
Keep the lure moving. Slowly on the water so it looks like a little fish just asking to be eaten. Don't give up, Arthur. You'll get the hang of it.
They're nibbling.
There we go.
There he is.
Damn it, I lost him. Are you trying to make your lure look like a dead fish? They won't be interested if it ain't moving.
You got a bite there, Arthur. That's on the hook, Arthur.
Something's nibbling. Got one! Shit, got away.
I think that's a bite. There, hooked him.
Got a bite. Got ya!
beauty.
There you go.
Well done, Arthur.
They can grow a lot bigger than that. Fella told me he once saw a monster lake sturgeon near the mouth of the river, just southwest of Saint Denis. 50-pounder, he reckoned.
I would like to see that. Hey, Hosea. You remember that time we sent Arthur out fishing? He came back with three beautiful...
Hey, I reckon we call it a day, fellas.
Already?
You ain't been chasing down outlaws.
All right. Think we got a decent haul here. Pearson will be happy. Should we head back?
We could keep the boat not too far back to camp from here.
Good idea. Could be useful.
What about the horses?
They'll find their way back.
Just follow the shore south, Arthur.
That was fun.
Uh-huh.
Thank you, boys. Now, Hosea.
Yes.
How about a song?
Okay. All right, I got one for you. I asked that gal to give me some.
I asked that gal to give me some. She says, wait till the taters is done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. I couldn't wait till the taters was done. Threw her on the floor and I knocked off some. I wish to God I'd passed her by. I wish to God I'd passed her by. Taters got burnt and so did I.
That was pretty good. But you know, what song we should be singing?
What?
Well, look at us. We mariners.
Ah, of course.
Well, we be three poor mariners, newly come from the seas. We spend our lives in jeopardy while others live at ease. Shall we go dance this round, round, round? Shall we go dance this round, round, round? Maiden is a bully boy, come pledge me on this round, 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 round. We care not for the martial men that do our states disdain, but we care for the merchantmen that do our states maintain. To them we dance this round, round, round. To them we dance this round, round, round. And he that is a bully boy, come pledge me on this ground, the ground, the ground, the ground, the ground, the ground, the ground.
Oh, bravo! Bravo! Well, you know, we should not let the folks back at camp think we had too much fun.
Indeed not.
We gonna be okay. I know. Well, I always know. Whenever I got you two by my side, things are gonna be just fine. This place will be good for us. For now, anyway.
I hope so.